Cold and Good afternoon and welcome to the University of Washington MEDEX Northwest Spokane Class 22 graduation ceremony. I'm Heidi Elder, Program Coordinator for the Spokane campus. I have the privilege of being your MC for today's graduation celebration. Also joining me is an honorary PA graduate, Cormac, who joined Spokane Class 22 in winter quarter of didactic year. He was 11 weeks old and literally grew up with this wonderful cohort of students. So graduates, you did get your wish. Cormac is attending your graduation, although he will not be walking across the stage with you. He is here beside me cheering you on. I want to commend all of you on honoring your commitments and finishing strong. You have faced challenges no other class has had to endure, and you remain the same cohesive and supportive group of individuals who made Spokane Class 22 an amazing group. I think all of us can agree that we would much rather been celebrating in person in August, but we are thankful we can celebrate you in this virtual format. Please help me in thanking the following people for the behind the scenes work to make this day possible. Toby Blake and Kiana Scholl from Student Services, Jim Waymeyer from the Communications Team, and Nathan Hart from IT. They have worked tirelessly to ensure that all four graduation ceremonies are the special and memorable events that you deserve. Since we're having this ceremony in a virtual format, I'd like to go over some technical information. Graduates, you are considered panelists in this format. Please mute your cameras and microphones until the presentation of graduates. When you see your slide and hear mic call your name, please turn on both your camera and audio so that you and your fan club who is with you can cheer, throw confetti, say a few words, whatever, to celebrate your achievement. It is your moment. When you are finished, please mute your microphone and video so that the next classmate can enjoy their moment. To all of the guests who are not physically with the graduates, you are considered attendees in this format. There is a chat function that you are encouraged to use to cheer on the graduates during the student awards and presentation of graduates. Just be sure to click to both attendees and panelists, both, so that graduates and guests can view your congratulatory messages. You can follow along with the graduation program that is available online. The ceremony will be recorded and made available on the MEDEX YouTube channel in about 24 to 48 hours after the ceremony. Now, I would like to begin the ceremony by introducing our MEDEX Northwest Director and Section Head, Terry Scott.
Thank you, Heidi. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Terry Scott, and I'm the MEDEX Program Director, and I'd like to welcome you to the MEDEX virtual graduation. We're all glad that you're here. Spokane Class 22, congratulations. It's been one heck of a year. No one imagined that we would spend most of this year social distancing, wearing face masks, and debating the realities of science. You have demonstrated tremendous resilience and flexibility in attaining your goal of becoming a physician assistant. In March of this year, our world was turned upside down by the reality of COVID-19. Washington State was ground zero. As a result, all of our students were pulled from their clinical rotations. In what would be a difficult year in a normal year, became a very challenging year for this group. And I want to commend you for your resilience and flexibility and for your persistence in attaining your goal of becoming a physician assistant. So congratulations, it is a well-earned achievement. You recall that it was over 2 years ago that I welcomed you to the MEDEX program. At that time, you were embarking on a journey that would be one of the most challenging and rewarding in your career. Today, that journey ends and a new one begins. The opportunity to practice as a physician assistant is a privilege. You are now equipped with the knowledge and skills to deliver competent care to patients. And in a world where COVID has changed everything, the next 20 to 30 years, you will be dealing with the realities of the chronic conditions that COVID will leave our nation and our world with. In the future, the very lives of individuals will depend on the decisions you make. Take this responsibility seriously and do the most good. I want to talk about what to expect for the rest of the day. I want to also thank the guests who are attending. Today, we're going to hear from some dignitaries. We're going to hear from a keynote speaker. We're going to hear from the student speakers. We're going to offer up some awards, and then we're going to hand out the certificates and then the closing ceremony. And to get us started, I would like to say that the University of Washington's Gonzaga Partnership was established in 2016. This allowed for the continued education of medical students and physician assistant students here in the Spokane area. This partnership continues to evolve, and soon there'll be a new and improved classroom for both the MEDEX students and the medical students. Bringing greetings from our host institution is Dr. Thane McCullough, Gonzaga President.
Thank you for inviting me to join you today. It is a privilege to be part of your celebration. I wish we were meeting in person, and I look forward to the day that we can be together and mark this milestone, even belatedly, with a handshake. On behalf of everyone here at Gonzaga University, our most heartfelt congratulations and compliments to each of you on the completion of your studies. We are proud to have been a part of your journey and are so grateful for your commitment to your chosen profession of care and healing. I remember that many of you joined us last year around this time when we announced the new facility for medical education, health sciences, and innovation with McKinstry and the UW School of Medicine. How great it was to see you there representing the true purpose of that new building. You, the future. I hope you will come back and join us when it opens in August of 2022. You remind each of us of the importance of team in healthcare. Each member bringing unique skills and playing a specific role in caring for patients and in building a community culture of health and wellness. You are a group that persevered, stayed together, supported each other, and handled more than your share of complex and difficult challenges without complaining or giving up. Your resilience will serve you well in your profession, and it will serve your patients well too. And there's another trait that we see in you, courage. We know you've been helped by family and friends and your fellow students. But no one gets through such challenges without personal bravery. Whether you've needed support or provided it, thank you for stepping up. I can't think of a more challenging but important time to enter into practice than in the midst of the global pandemic. Thank you for embracing the challenge to bring your skills, resilience, and courage to the care of others during such suffering and uncertainty. We want you to remember always that you are valued members of our ZAG family. Our very best wishes and prayers go with you today and always.
Hi, I'm Daryl Podick. I'm the Associate Dean for Eastern Washington for the UW School of Medicine. And it's a pleasure for me to join you today to celebrate your graduation. It's really a momentous day, and I'm glad to be able to share it with you. As we do that, I'd like to start with a couple of things. One is to say, you know, normally I'd be there in person with you and celebrating with you, and I hope that doing it virtually doesn't in any way diminish what we're doing and recognizing all you've gone through and your accomplishments. So, wanted to say that right up front, but then also I think it's important that we think, when we think about graduations, that we remember that nothing good ever happens in a vacuum. And this is a good thing, so it hasn't happened in a vacuum. And all of you have had good people who have help you along the way, help you to get here in some small or in many cases, many big ways. So I'd like to acknowledge your friends, your families, and your significant others who have supported you along your journey to where you are today. Normally, we would ask for a round of applause, but I hope that you can look at that person, remember them, and remember to express your gratitude for their help along the way. So I'd like to move now to graduations. Like I said, they're a culmination of lots of hard work and a sense of accomplishment, but also a glimpse of what lies ahead. So what does lie ahead? This is a great time to be in medicine. Things are changing so very, very quickly. Patient care and medicine as a whole are changing, and they're becoming much more of a team sport, with high-functioning teams caring for individuals, but also for populations. We can make a big, big difference. In the past, we've given lip service to medicine being a team sport, but things are changing. We're moving from a team sport like golf, where individuals work in parallel, to something more like volleyball, where each team member works in concert with another for a common goal. As physician's assistants, you're going to be key players in these exciting times. Yesterday you were a student, and today you enter, and some of you will re-enter, the medical profession. Yet you're always going to be a student, a professional student. I mentioned that once to a group of high school students. They looked at me with absolute terror in their eyes. And although I can't see you, I'm trusting that you don't have that same terror, that you're embracing your role as a professional student. From here, some of you will go into primary care. Others will spend times in the operating room, whilst others will be in super specialized fields. Whatever your path, the next phase of your career will have a lot for you to learn. You'll have to learn about the field itself, but also from and about those you'll be working with. This will be an exciting time to put to good use all of the things you've been learning. Once you get comfortable, though, there will be a tendency to become complacent. Please don't let that happen. You're entering a profession and you will be a lifelong student. You'll need to be following the latest developments. You'll need to be using the best evidence and practices as they relate to patient care. I want to emphasize the word profession. People come to us when they're at their most vulnerable. They're sick, they're not feeling well, and they're looking at you and trusting in you. Yet at the same time, the medical profession has never been under more scrutiny, and at times is viewed through a skeptical lens. But you have an opportunity, and perhaps a responsibility, to ensure that our profession is seen in the best possible light. It doesn't take much, just remembering the things you've learned, giving patients the time they need, treating each and every one of them with respect, and offering them the best possible care. Through these simple actions and your individual and collective integrity, you will ensure the medical profession of which you are now a member will be seen in the highest esteem. I'd like to close with a quote from my hero in medical education, Sir William Osler, who said, "It's more important to know what patient has a disease than what disease the patient has." With that, I'll close. Congratulations, thank you, and I look forward to working with you side by side as colleagues. Cheers.
Congratulations to the MEDEX graduates of 2020. I am so excited for all of you. This is such a big milestone for you. I know many of you have come to be here at the MEDEX program through different paths. You've had different family experiences, different career experiences, different educational experiences, but all of those things have led you here to being a physician assistant. The support of your family and friends, and definitely your teachers throughout your lifetime, have made a significant difference. And to all of them, I say thank you, and I hope you'll thank them as well. It really does take all of us to train the next generation. So thank you to all who have participated in that. You're graduating at a unique time, starting your careers at a unique time, but it's also very exciting. I know for me, because of the pandemic, I'm learning new things. I'm learning new ways to take care of people who have contracted the coronavirus. I hope for all of you, you will continue to take opportunities throughout your careers to really continue to learn. Find out what's new. Find out what's going to help take care of your patients. So that lifelong learning component, I hope, really is solidified for you as you're entering medicine at this very unique time. There's a saying by a physician, Edward Trudeau, from the 1800s that says, to cure sometimes, to relieve often, to care always. I always think of that when I think about healthcare providers, the healthcare team. We know that we are not going to be able to cure everyone. And in fact, most times we can't find a cure. We know that we can relieve often, and to care always is so important. That listening when you're with a patient, that touch when you're examining a patient, and really understanding what they need from you at that time makes the world of difference for your patients. So as you go out and you begin your career, please remember our role is to always care for our patients. And hopefully we relieve their symptoms often, and hopefully sometimes we're able to cure them. So I want to congratulate you again. This is just such an exciting time for all of you. I look forward to having you as colleagues as you go out and practice. So congratulations, MEDEX graduates of 2020.
On behalf of the School of Medicine at the University of Washington and the Department of Family Medicine, I would like to welcome our MEDEX Northwest Physician Assistant graduates, their families, and our faculty. First, I would like to thank you all for the important role that you had in our graduate success today. Without you, this day doesn't happen. I also want to give a special thanks to our faculty for your important role in this day. And finally, to our graduates, thank you for the hard work you've done over the last 2 years during these trying times of a COVID-19 pandemic that has disrupted the very fabric of our healthcare system and society. Throughout this adversity, you have demonstrated your professionalism and excellence, and I am personally very proud of all of you. Healthcare in America is a complex enterprise. Being smart is not enough anymore. Being caring and hardworking, though important, is not enough. But being part of an outstanding team committed to these values, well, that's what can make great healthcare in America. The profession of the physician assistant was created specifically to enhance the functioning of healthcare teams. From my very first day in practice as a family physician, I have worked with knowledgeable and caring physician assistants from whom I have learned much. In my rural practice as a young physician, my first two physician assistants were Vietnam veterans who had a world of experience that I did not have access to. I learned much from them. You are all joining a vibrant profession that will continue to gain in importance as we struggle to deliver better health care here in America. But let me stop for just a moment and remind us all of why we are here today. Because while it seems that this day is for you and your important accomplishments, I want to remind us that tomorrow is about others. Not to frighten any of our graduates, but think about it. At this moment, There's an individual out there who is on an uncharted course and whose life will depend upon the knowledge, the skills, and the right actions that you take by virtue of your training here at MEDEX. This person will call you and will come to you with the expectation of healing. That person's story has begun, and you will become part of their story. I end today by celebrating your accomplishments as graduates of MEDEX. Thank you for your hard work. Thank you for your commitment. And I look forward to seeing many of you in the future as you join the healthcare workforce. Thank you.
It is my distinct pleasure to be joining you at this important moment in your lives. I'd like to begin by congratulating you on your graduation, congratulating you on completing your education as a physician assistant in some of the most challenging times I have seen in my career. If I was to reflect on the obstacles that you faced, I'm not sure I would want to enumerate them to complete your education as physician assistants at a time when healthcare is changing faster than it's ever changed before, being impacted by the COVID pandemic, both clinically and financially. How that has changed our ability to care for patients, to do that in a safe environment, and to focus on education, to focus on clinical education. You have overcome enormous obstacles, and I think that will prepare you in a way that perhaps others have not had the opportunity to prepare. By completing your education in such a time of, I'll say, emergency or crisis, that's a bit like a stress test. And you have been stressed, but you have passed. And you have passed now to graduation. The UW School of Medicine is so pleased to have the MEDEX program as part of the School of Medicine. Our mission is to improve health for all people. And physician assistants are absolutely critical members of the healthcare team to improve health for all people. Whether you'll be going into a career in primary care or specialty medicine, you'll be focused on improving health for all people. I'm confident in your abilities. I'm confident and very pleased with the quality of our faculty. I congratulate you and wish you the very best going forward.
Thank you for those wonderful messages from Gonzaga University and the University of Washington. It is now my honor to introduce our keynote speaker, who is a graduate of MEDEX Spokane Class Number 1. She works as a physician assistant at Mann Grand Staff VA Medical Center and is also the commissioner for the Washington Medical Association. More than that, she has such a strong commitment to our students and donates her time and knowledge to educate future physician assistants. Please welcome Teresa Schimmels.
Good afternoon and welcome to Spokane Class 22, MEDEX Northwest. My name is Teresa Schimmels and I am a graduate of Spokane Class 1. I work currently as a dermatology PA at the VA, where I've not only worked in dermatology over the last few months, but also worked with the COVID response team. What a strange time you've all been through this last few months, having to wear masks, missing out on school, having to do things like this, a Zoom graduation. Who would have thought that we'd ever be in this position? I want to applaud all of you, though, for staying healthy as we've gone through this. If you had gotten sick and had not been able to finish school, you wouldn't be here today. So make sure you continue to wash your hands and wear those masks. One of the things I'd like to talk about today is patient care. And my emphasis is listening to the patient. Every patient tells a story and they want to be heard. If you can just take a few seconds to let that patient do that, it means the world to them. Remember that patients are scared and they're anxious. We're somewhat scared and anxious too at times, not knowing what the patient brings to us. There was a study a few years ago that showed that a medical provider, that would be an MD, nurse practitioner, or a PA, would interrupt the patient before 18 seconds passed in the patient encounter. If we can give that patient 45 seconds or a minute at least to talk about their problem, keep your lips sealed, sit on your hands, or take notes and glance reassuringly at the patient, get your face out of the computer and give them your attention, you'll be a much better provider and the patient will be much more appreciative. Time is hard. We're working in a world where we have to go, go, go in medicine. It's not the medicine of the old days when you could take a visit and with a patient that could last 30 minutes or an hour. Most of that time is spent on the computer now. So make sure, again, you take your head out of the computer, look at the patient. Don't forget to be timely, but don't rush. If you need to, reschedule that patient and talk with them later on down the road about the next problem or the next concern they have if it's non-emergent. The other thing about time is making sure that you take time out for your family. It's really hard nowadays when you're working 40 to 60 hour weeks, and some of you will work those types of jobs. Most medical practices do not just work a basic 40 hour week. So if you thought that that was what was going to happen when you became a PA, it's time to brush that off and move forward. But make sure that when you leave work, that you leave work at work. Be with your family, spend time with your friends. Do the things you need to do for self-care to make sure that your mind and body are whole so that you can be whole for both your patients and your staff. The last thing I'd like to talk to is to take time to visit with your staff and get to know your staff. That goes from the janitor or the housekeeper or the scheduler or the operator or the person in the dining hall that serves your soup or your sandwich, to the nurses and the aides and the respiratory therapists and the ortho techs and whatever it is that you're going to be around. All of those people make your life easier. Knowing who they are and acknowledging them is one of the first things that you should do in creating a relationship that will help build your career in a positive manner. The same goes with patients. Be positive with them. Be encouraging. Again, they're anxious. They're scared. They don't know what's wrong with them. Make sure you spend the time with your patients. And back to your family, the same thing. They may be anxious and scared as well. Make sure you spend the time that you need to really listen to your spouse, significant other, partner, children, mom or dad. Our life would be so much better if we would just take a little bit of time. I am available for anyone if you ever have a dermatology question or a problem. I really appreciate being asked to speak today, and I'd like to thank MEDEX for nominating me for the Lifetime Achievement Award this last spring. I feel very honored to be here once again to present the class of Spokane MEDEX 22. Have a great life, have a great year, and keep on keeping on. Thank you.
Thank you, Teresa, for being such an inspiration. Isn't she fantastic? Next, we have the introduction of class officers and student speakers, along with the recognition of military service by our former Spokane site director and faculty member, Michael Smith.
Hello, Spokane class 22. What a great day. I'm so happy and I'm so proud of each and every one of you. I wish we could do this in person. I could shake your hands, meet your families, and give everybody a great big hug. You all certainly deserve it. Right now, it's my pleasure to introduce the Spokane Class 22 president, who is going to speak on behalf of the class and also introduce the rest of the class officers. Once he is done, I will come back on for a second and introduce someone else. I'm not going to say who it is, but if you're following along your program, you'll know. But anyway, right now, I'd like to introduce and in Sheffield, Spokane Class 22 President. Sir.
Spokane Class 22, congratulations. You did it. Well done. It's been a journey. It's been a road. A road full of twists and turns and bumps and some really, really long stoplights. But we made it. We're at the end. It's here at the end that we must not forget who we are, where we came from, and more importantly, who we were meant to be as practitioners. Let's not also forget those that have brought us to this road, those who have walked this road with us, and those who, without their support, we would not have finished this road. Personally, I'd like to thank my wife, Rachel, for the beautiful woman that she is, for raising me and our two kids during this insane journey. Without her, this reality would still be a dream. Also, thank you, classmates, for your role in getting me through this and getting your other cohort through this, too. Without your jokes, your laughter, your cynicism, and your study groups, we wouldn't have been able to do it. Thank you, professors and preceptors, for imparting your knowledge and molding us into future practitioners. Remember, class, we are not individual practitioners, but the total sums of those friends, families, teachers, and mentors in our life. Thank you all, and without further ado, let me introduce you to your Spokane Class 22 government. Spokane Class Vice President, Heidi Human. Spokane Class Secretary, Brittany Brady. Spokane Class Treasurer, Danielle Braggett. Spokane Class Assembly of Representatives, Representative Lauren True. Spokane Class Director of Community Outreach, Manpreet Kaur. WAPA Student Representative, Tyler Hoff. Spokane Director of Community Outreach, Brittany Big D Dvorak. Assemblies of Representative, Alternate, Spencer Winberry. Class Historian, Kyle Robles. Class Social Directors, Alex Hammond and Bianca Serafini. Class 22, Spokane Medical Society Representative, Cody Holmes.
All right. Thank you, Annan, for that very entertaining introduction of all the class officers. Next, it's my pleasure to introduce Heidi Human, Spokane Class 22 Vice President, and she's going to speak to you on behalf of the class.
Hello and welcome, friends, family, spouses, MEDEX faculty, staff, and Spokane Class 22. Thank you all for being here today and joining me virtually from the beautiful state of Wyoming, where social distancing is our innate lifestyle. I am very humbled and grateful to be giving this speech today. My hope is to provide a collective voice on behalf of this cohort, to say something that might resonate, and to share a glimpse into these last years of PA school. I would like to take a minute to thank our wonderful faculty, staff, guest lecturers, and preceptors for everything they do for us. And additionally, thank you for assembling this hardworking, amazing motley crew of brilliant and empathetic individuals. A collective huge thank you to our support systems, the family, spouses, and friends who are here to support us through this journey. Today would not be possible without all of you. Our success as students was not done alone. You may have seen sides of us that you've never seen before, may never want to see again, or maybe you didn't see much of us at all. But know that today is a true celebration for all of us and the sacrifices we all made. I would like to share a question that was once proposed to be my preceptor. Picture yourself. It's 1935 and you're Mahatma Gandhi. You're running to catch a train, and just as you're running to board the train, one of your sandals falls off and lands on the track. What do? Do you board the train and carry on, or do you go back to the platform and retrieve your sandal? Now I want you to hold on to that question, and we'll come back to that at the end. And I must first say, I have no conflicts of interest or financial disclosures to declare. Though I should declare that when I sat down the many, many times to write this speech, I truly discovered the meaning of procrastination and learned the world of wonders of Microsoft Synonym Tool. But also during that time, I reflected on these past years of PA school and what a memorable journey this cohort of dedicated learners has experienced together, and how privileged I feel to be among such brilliant minds. My remarkable classmates sitting before you come from all walks of life with such remarkable backgrounds in healthcare. And if I had the time today, I would share all their wonderful stories with you. But instead, I will take you all on a brief voyage of what we experienced during PA school together. A wise man once said, "Great moments come from great opportunities." And for us, our great opportunity was offered back in 2018 when we first became PA students. Let's remember back to when we all first arrived in Seattle, full of pep and vinegar. We learned of Dr. Richard Smith, the founder of MEDEX. We wore matching purple t-shirts, experienced our first lectures as PA students, and thus began our deep understanding into the guy in the desert, the saber-toothed tiger, and learned the workings of a genetic Punnett square, big D, little d. Then, in the blink of an eye, we were all off to start in Spokane. Let us not forget those fond memories, our first CRAs, sweating through our white coats, studying, cramming, our first exams, EM simulation labs, the papers, the more papers, and then we all remember the lifelong friendships we made, our class parties, and celebrating the end of didactic year. Then before we knew it, we were starting rotations and then restarting rotations during a pandemic. Never forget your first patient, the first time you spoke up, and then the second time you spoke up and actually had the correct answer. How nervous you were for our first rotations, learning to never say oops, or has anyone seen my watch while in the OR? The showing up early, the staying late, the traveling, the Airbnbs, the hotels, the time away from loved ones, and the sacrifice of being alone. Never forget the missed anniversaries, birthdays, weddings, births, and funerals, and the constant thought of having to study. I know some of you are thinking about studying for boards right now, so stop it. Most importantly, we should all try and forget the time of iHuman assignments. At points, it may have felt like this day may never come. Preparing to take our boards, interviewing for jobs, and embracing our calling as PAs. Patients will come to us in their most vulnerable times, and it's now our duty to use what we learned, practice, and perfected over the years. Oh yes, and before I forget, Gandhi and the station. So how many people would have gone to the train and left the sandal? And how many people would have gone back to retrieve your sandal? Well, let me tell you what he actually did. He took off his remaining sandal, threw it under the train, and onto the track. And when his companion asked, "Why did you do that?" he responded, "So whomever finds this will have a complete pair of sandals." This story truly reminds me of the compassion, values, and rationale of thinking under pressure of every single one of my classmates. It is said that patients forget most of what you say during an encounter, but they will never forget how you make them feel. So I will save the most important thing I have to say here for the very end. I leave you with, remember today, remember this moment right now, remember how you feel, because with great privilege comes great responsibility. So never forget why you chose to become a PA, and continue to choose that each day of practice. Congratulations, Spokane Class 22. We made it.
Thank you, Heidi. That was brilliant. That was a brilliant speech. I appreciate that very much. Great story, by the way. All right, among my other duties today, this is one of the most important ones for me personally. It's the recognition of military service. So it is my distinct pleasure today to recognize military service among our PA graduates. But before we do this, please indulge me with a brief historical perspective that is pertinent to our graduation ceremony. In the mid-1960s, physician shortages and uneven distribution of primary care doctors were creating a strain on the nation's healthcare delivery system. At that same time, and despite the extensive medical training and experience among military combat medics, there was no corresponding civilian healthcare provision where these skilled veterans could make full use of their expertise. A remarkable visionary, Dr. Eugene Stead Jr., then chairman of the Department of Medicine at Duke University, believed that a new breed of practitioners could increase consumer access to healthcare services. Thus, he enrolled the first class of former military medics into a new program designed to train physician extenders. In doing so, Dr. Stead developed this new curriculum based partly on the fast-track physician training implemented by the military during World War II. Subsequently, the very first PAs graduated in 1967. In the late 1960s, Dr. Richard Smith also recognized this need, particularly throughout the rural communities of the Pacific Northwest. After receiving funds for a federal demonstration project in 1969, Dr. Smith enrolled the first class of former military medics and corpsmen into the new MEDEX Northwest program at the University of Washington in Seattle. Ever since those early years, MEDEX has proudly led the way with the highest percentage of veterans students in a civilian PA program. As you see, military veterans have provided a rich tradition and innumerable contributions to the PA profession. So it is with great honor today that I recognize military service among our current graduates, faculty, staff, and those in the audience. I will now call out the names of military veterans among MEDEX Spokane Class 22. For those of you celebrating at home, please help me recognize the following individuals for their service. Kyle Fredekind, United States Air Force. Cody Holm, United States Army. Luke Hopkins, United States Marine Corps. Anna Zakharova, United States Navy. Lastly, if you're reviewing this presentation with a veteran, please reach out and shake their hand or give them a big hug and thank them for the service to our country.
Thank you, Michael, and all of our veterans in the audience for service to our country. Next is a Preceptor of the Year Award being presented by Spokane Site Director and amazing clinical coordinator, Theo Orchard.
Thank you, Heidi. Of course, you know, as everybody else has mentioned, I wish we could be doing this in person. And meeting your family, shaking their hands, and being able to congratulate you guys. This is typically where I'd have, you know, the preceptors in attendance stand and recognize them for all the hard work they do in dedicating their time and their efforts to supporting you over the course of this year. As you all know, our preceptors do not get paid for their efforts, but one student at a time, they dedicate their services. They go home late, stay late charting, do what they can so they can spend time between patients, talking with our students and helping them become great medical providers. So each year, MEDEX, each MEDEX campus is able to select a preceptor to recognize as the preceptor of the year. This is an award which we bestow at graduation each year to the preceptor who has exemplified the values we look for in a clinical preceptor and has contributed significantly to the education of our students. We have students nominate preceptors who stand out throughout their rotations, as well as we thoroughly review the students' evaluations of the rotations and their evaluations of their preceptor. So this year's Preceptor of the Year award goes to Dr. Jacob Camp. Dr. Camp works at the Eastern State Hospital in inpatient psychiatry. Dr. Camp, he was nominated back in February at our first campus week. Students were polled and asked to nominate preceptors that stood out to them. Dr. Camp was nominated by multiple students who brought his and submitted his name. And some of the comments I talked about, you know, the time he would take away, the reading assignments he would provide, and, you know, the fact that you would go the extra mile. One of the notes was, Dr. Camp is an amazing practitioner as well as an amazing person. Any student would greatly benefit from his expertise. He is able to pass on his knowledge in an effective manner. I cannot emphasize enough how invaluable this rotation was to my future as a PAC. Just 1 month later, students were removed from their clinical rotations and their clinical education was put on hold. As soon as we were able to resume clinical rotations, Dr. Camp was the first to step up and to speak out and offer his services, obligating himself to hosting a student every single month to make sure that these students get across the finish line. Since beginning as a preceptor for MEDEX in 2016, Dr. Camp has hosted 38 PA students, equating to over 6,080 hours of volunteer time for our program and our students. Please join me in congratulating and thanking Dr. Jacob Camp.
Hello from a pre-recorded time and a comfortable place. I am Jacob Camp, and I've been honored to be the MEDEX Preceptor of the Year of 2020. I've had the privilege to spend up to a month with some remarkable individuals who have opted in their full maturity to devote their lives to grappling with direct health care. We have met on an admitting ward for long-term civilly committed patients at Eastern State Hospital, and I've watched many of you adapt your expectations and try to relate to the complex and perplexing atmosphere surrounding institutional mental health care delivery. I've marveled at your subsequent mastery of the mental status examination and the rudimentary clinical skills necessary to follow a patient's progress. Each of you has carried an inspired joie de vivre that only a grounded and principled training program can inculcate. I thank MEDEX for the opportunity to share my values and my clinical skills with so many worthy students over these last few years. May you all react first with compassion to those oppressed by chronic illnesses of any kind. Thanks again for this honor, and may you all stay COVID-free.
Thank you, Dr. Camp, for your commitment to our students. Next, we have Patty Hahn, Spokane Didactic Coordinator, faculty, and three-time Golden Apple winner. She will now present the 2020 Golden Apple winners.
Thanks, Heidi. It's my pleasure to present the Golden Apple Awards for Excellence in Teaching. Golden Apples are awarded to outstanding guest lecturers. Although the MEDEX faculty provide the majority of training in the classroom, we do invite several specialists from the community to share their expertise with our students. Golden Apple winners are selected each quarter by the MEDEX students. This year's Golden Apple Award winners are Dr. Bruce Cutter. Dr. Cutter is a practicing hematologist with Summit Cancer Centers and teaches the daunting subject of white blood cell disorders as part of the pathophysiology course. As you can imagine, this is a very difficult subject for the students to grasp. Here's what some of our students had to say about Dr. Cutter's lecture. Really engaging and in-depth discussion of a complex subject. Dr. Cutter made an intimidating subject simple and easy to understand. Incredibly knowledgeable and skilled at making the material relatable to students. It is my pleasure to present a Golden Apple Award to Dr. Bruce Cutter. Unfortunately, Dr. Cutter is not available to be here live with us today, but let me read his acceptance speech. First, a deep and sincere congratulations for your graduation. I do so wish I could be extending such congratulations to you in person, yet that is not the reality of the world we live in at the moment. Second, thank you so much for the honor of teaching you hematology. It is a subject I am passionate about and a subject you will draw upon your knowledge base nearly every day of your professional life. And especially thank you for the amazing Golden Apple Award in recognition of my teaching. It's hard to communicate in the written word, but I want to tell you all what an honor it is that I have been chosen by you for this award. Third, let us look to the future. Now keep in mind, I grew up in Long Island, a suburb of New York City, and I was a big Yankees fan. Yogi Berra, Yankees player, manager, and master of words, said, "It's hard to make predictions, especially about the future." So following Yogi, I have no intention of making predictions, although I do have a few brief thoughts about the world you're in, and that will be changing as you move throughout your career. Number one, always do the right thing. Number two, always give a damn about those you serve. Number three, teach. And in doing so, you elevate others and yourself. Number four, I would ask you to think about leadership. We always talk about management. We manage diabetes, we manage chest pain. Lost in this is an opportunity to lead patients, families, colleagues, communities, the state, and even the nation. As healthcare provider, you will be looked up to and respected. We have many, many challenges awaiting solutions in healthcare and our society. I strongly believe it is contingent on all providers to lead, not just manage. To make a difference on a one-to-one or a one-to-many level, it takes a village, it takes a community, it takes a nation to truly move toward a better world. I encourage all of you to realize and accept this challenge and contribute in any way you can. Thank you again for this special opportunity and this very special award. Good luck and good skill, Dr. Bruce Cutter. The second Golden Apple is awarded to one of our emergency medicine guest lecturers, Dr. Eric Gilbert. Dr. Gilbert is a practicing ear, nose, and throat specialist. For the past several years, he's taught the ear, nose, and throat emergencies class. We keep bringing him back because the students love him. He always brings a box of equipment that he passes around the classroom and often is accompanied by a PA who just happens to be a MEDEX graduate. Plus, he has great stories and gross pictures. What's not to love about seeing a surgical repair of a mandibular orbital fracture? Let me share some student comments. Very engaging and enthusiastic speaker. The props were helpful in learning and visualizing. Dr. Gilbert was fantastic. He was engaging and presented the material in a fun and easy way to understand. It is my pleasure to present a Golden Apple Award to Dr. Eric Gilbert. Dr. Gilbert was also unable to join us today, but wanted to share these comments with you. I'm touched by this award. Thank you so much. I wish each of you success in your lives and careers as physician assistants. The great joy of the medical life is found in the continuous pursuit of understanding and knowledge for the benefit of your patients. Thank you, Dr. Eric Gilbert. Our final Golden Apple Award is given to Dr. Andrew Yabusaki. Dr. Yabusaki is a PharmD, a clinical staff pharmacist, and an academic fellow with Washington State University. He presents two lectures in the patient management course. He gives our students a firm foundation in pharmacology with a lecture on pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics, basically what the drug does to the body and what the body does to the drug. He also teaches a class on medications used to treat epilepsy. Let me share with you some student comments about Dr. Yabusaki's presentations. Great speaker, great energy and confidence. Made what could have been a fairly boring lecture very interesting and clear. Enjoyed his enthusiasm and excitement for the topic. Kept the class engaged. A fantastic lecturer. He was engaging, funny, and simplified a difficult topic. It is my pleasure to present the Golden Apple Award for Teaching Excellence to Dr. Andrew Yabusaki.
Hello, and congratulations, class of 2020. You not only persevered through a global pandemic, but also through my lecture on pharmacokinetics and dynamics. I am humbled by this recognition. As a new instructor, I cannot begin to describe the significance that this sort of feedback carries. It really just adds to my momentum building my career. So thank you very much. You all were a true joy to instruct, possessing keen minds, and I'm so proud that you have joined the ranks of healthcare practitioners. And now that you're out there, I sincerely hope that you all are continuing your path of enrichment and learning. Healthcare is really done best when we learn from each other. It is the ultimate team sport. And as I was a pharmacist teaching you as physician assistants, I hope that you all will teach other physicians, pharmacists, nurses, technicians, students of all disciplines throughout your career. Please never turn down a moment to share your knowledge with us. We know you're all very, very bright, and we're excited to see where you go. You know, part of me is a little bit sad that the ceremony couldn't be exactly what you all wanted and definitely deserve. But at the end of the day, I rest easy knowing that wherever you'll go, patients will be well taken care of. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters. I look forward to seeing you all out there sometime soon. Thank you again, and congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Patty, and congratulations to Dr. Cutter, Dr. Gilbert, and Dr. Yabusaki. We will now move on to the student awards. Students, if you are the recipient of one of these upcoming awards, please turn on your video and microphone after your name is announced so we can enjoy celebrating with you. Please welcome Sarah Serpinas, Spokane faculty, MEDEX graduate, and winner of the Spokane Class 12 Spirit of MEDEX Award. Sarah will be presenting the John Coombs Leadership Award.
All right, good afternoon, everyone. Before I present this first award, I just wanted to say that it has been an honor to work with you these last 2 years, and I really look forward to working with you all as colleagues. Our graduates have really stepped up over the last 6 months and have done some amazing things, and you should all be proud of joining such an awesome group of people. So this first student award that we're presenting today is the John B. Coombs Leadership Award. Dr. John B. Coombs served as the University of Washington School of Medicine Associate Dean for Regional Affairs and Rural Health, and in this capacity, he oversaw the WAMI program. He was known as a national leader who greatly improved healthcare in underserved and rural communities, and in addition to this, he had a long record of promoting the PA profession. The Coombs Leadership Award is presented to one student at each training site who has become a role model to their peers, a student that assumed leadership responsibilities during their training and carried out those responsibilities with integrity, cooperation, and understanding. The individual selected by the Spokane faculty this year took on a leadership role early in his didactic year. He really stepped up in his clinical year when things got crazy and he and his classmates were removed from their rotations. He worked with our faculty and staff and helped to bring forward concerns from his classmates and then relay our responses. He displayed tremendous professionalism during one of the most demanding times that we have gone through as a program. This year's recipient of the John B. Coombs Leadership Award is our Spokane Class 22 President, Annan Sheffield. Congrats, Annan.
Woo!
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah, and congratulations, Annan. Next, we have the Barbara Gunter Flynn Underserved Award being presented by a Spokane faculty member who works tirelessly to provide care for the underserved and homeless, TJ Byrne.
Hi, and good afternoon. I'm TJ Byrne. I am MEDEX Spokane site faculty. Before presenting the next award, I'd like to say thank you and congratulations to our 2020 MEDEX graduates. Thank you for your patience, perseverance, and hard work, and congratulations on completing your PA studies under very difficult circumstances. In addition to congratulations, I would like to extend congratulations to your amazing families as well, who have been so supportive along your journey to becoming a physician assistant. It's my honor and privilege today to present the Barbara Gunter Flynn Award for Commitment to Underserved Populations. This is an award that's presented to a Spokane student upon graduation. Let me tell you a little bit more. This award is dedicated to honor the legacy of Barb. Sadly, Barb passed away in 2002 after a courageous battle with cancer. She left us, however, with a legacy of service to PA education and providing access to medical care for the most underserved. The winner of this year's award is Heidi Yeomans. I've never met Barb, nor have I ever met Heidi, but in doing my research for this award, I noted some amazing similarities. The terms strength, courage, commitment, savvy, and dedication were common threads in reading about Barb and in talking to people about Heidi. According to Heidi's clinical coordinator and academic advisor, she embodies the MEDEX mission and commitment to serving rural underserved communities. And it's my understanding that she intends to continue her work in rural Wyoming upon graduation. Congratulations, Heidi. And oh, by the way, please give Shay a dog treat for me.
Thank you, TJ, and congratulations, Heidi. Michael Smith will now present the Writing Award.
All right, I had to change. I had to get my regalia on here, so I look a little different, but it's still me. All right, the Student Writing Award. This is usually given by Karen Wick. She usually hands this out at graduations, but I get the honors today. So the Student Writing Award. This award is given to students at each campus who have combined creativity and unique approaches with exceptional writing skills in all assigned papers. MEDEX students write many papers over the course of this 27-month program. Papers are written in basic sciences, basic clinical skills, pathophysiology, technical skills, professional role development, behavioral medicine, adult medicine, and finally they culminate in a rather large and tedious capstone project. The winner of this year's Writing Award for Spokane hails from Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, and completed their undergraduate studies at Washington State University. From the earliest days in the program, I knew this individual was on the right track and was going to be an excellent PA. In this student's Each One Teach One assignment, the students shared the following quote, which is very fitting to today's ceremony and actually highlight on what Dr. James said earlier. Helping one person might not change the world, but it could change the world for one person. The winner of this year's Student Writing Award goes to Mark Smiley. Congratulations, Mark.
Thanks, Mike. Yeah, camera's on. We're good. Thanks so much, Mike. Good to see you.
Good to see you too, sir. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mike, and congratulations, Mark. Presenting the Spirit of MEDEX Award is Spokane faculty and graduate of Spokane Class 12, Carrie Rogers.
Congratulations to all of our graduates on your completion of the Physician Assistant Training Program here at MEDEX. My name is Carrie Rogers and I am a member of the Spokane faculty. I'm happy to be here today to present the Spirit of MEDEX Award. The Spirit of MEDEX Award recognizes a student at each campus site who has dedicated themselves to their goal of becoming a physician assistant, shown compassion and sensitivity to others, maintained their sense of humor and persevered in the face of adversity, who has a positive attitude and are ambassadors for the program. This person began their career in medicine as a medical assistant at the University of Washington. She was the recipient of the MEDEX Award Northwest Richard Smith Scholarship for her leadership potential and goals to innovate care for the LGBTQ and other urban underserved populations. She has served on the Student Academy of the AAPA as the Spokane Class 22 student representative on the Assembly of Representatives. During her time with the Academy, she became the Western Regional Director, helping to rewrite some of the PA Student Society bylaws. She was involved in community service throughout her 2 years at MEDEX, and last year she was able to set up a volunteer activity for the incoming first-year students to prepare a meal at the Ronald McDonald House. I am honored to present the Spokane Class 22 Spirit of MEDEX Award to Lauren True. Congratulations, Lauren.
Oh. Hi. Hi, everybody. Thank you, Carrie, and congratulations, Lauren. Well deserved, and it was great to see you this afternoon. Next up, we have Sarah Serpinas, who will now present the Mary Reed Award.
All right, hello again. It is my pleasure to present the Mary Reed Award today. I have to admit, this is my favorite award, and I really wanted this award in PA school, but did not win it. Mary Reed was a registered nurse who attended the MEDEX PA program in Seattle. While in the program, she met her husband and fellow PA student, Joe Reed. They graduated in 1983 from Seattle Class 16. Mary was very committed to academics and graduated at the top of her class. Unfortunately, her career as a PA was cut short due to breast cancer, and she died at the young age of 38. Shortly after her death, her husband, Joe, and the Washington Association of Physician Assistants established the Mary Reed Award to honor her commitment to academic excellence. This award is presented annually to the MEDEX student who has achieved the highest grade point average among all four MEDEX training sites, Seattle, Tacoma, Anchorage, and Spokane. I guess next year we're gonna have to add Hawaii to that list. So this award just goes to one student. So one student at all of our sites get this award for having the highest GPA. It has been 4 years since a Spokane student has won this award, so it's a big deal. And I am very proud of this year's recipient for her hard work and dedication to academic excellence, and I can't wait to see what she does in the future. This year, the award is presented to MEDEX Spokane Class 22 student, Julia Snyder. Congrats, Julia.
Oh, it's not. Hi, thank you.
Woo! Great job. Yeah!
They went rogue, I don't know, thanks.
Thank you, Sarah, and congratulations, Julia. What an amazing award, good job. Let's welcome back Michael Smith to present the Stephen Turnipseed Award.
All right, sounds like there's a party at Julia's house, and that's fantastic. So, all right, the next award we'd like to present is the Stephen Turnipseed Veterans Award. Stephen Turnipseed was an Army Special Forces medic during his military career. He was recognized for his achievements and professionalism while conducting counterinsurgency operations in Thailand during the Vietnam conflict. Stephen is a MEDEX Class 1 graduate. He was the first African-American to graduate from the program. Stephen is recognized as one of the 20 founding PAs in the nation and is a member of the PA Hall of Fame. He was the first PA to work for Group Health and was a founding board member of the American Academy of Physician Assistants. As you can see, Stephen Turnipseed was and is, in every sense of the word, a leader. The Stephen Turnipseed Veterans Award recognizes a MEDEX student who is a military veteran who demonstrated outstanding leadership within the MEDEX class and demonstrated exceptionally meritorious service within the local community. This year, I'm very proud to say that the Stephen Turnipseed Veteran Award goes to a very deserving individual who started his journey as a firefighter and an EMT in his home state of Montana. He has also served our country in Iraq, Kuwait, and Romania. This award goes to Cody Holm. Congratulations. All right. All right. Well, I hope everything is okay there at the Cody Home House. Congratulations, sir. All right. Now, we are going to move on to the moment that I think everybody has been waiting for, and that's the presentation of the 2020 class 2020 MEDEX graduates. Normally, when we have our ceremony live and in person, each student would stand up and walk across the stage. Patty would read their names. Between Sarah and I, we would present the students with their master's hood, and then they'd walk across the stage and receive their certificate from Terry Scott as the program director. Somehow I get to do all four of those things kind of in a virtual mode. So without further ado, let us welcome and congratulate Spokane Class 2022. Joshua Antles. And please, if you want to share your screen for a moment, say hello, say thank you. Congratulations are in order. Please share your screen.
Hi, everyone. It's not working.
Oh, no.
Brittany Colleen Sharan Brady.
Yeah, I think it's working. Can't stop it.
Danielle J. Braggett.
Turn on our camera.
Brandon James Sakachi.
Yeah, we go down. Yeah.
Bo Shaban. Gavin Dawson. Brittany Lynn Dvorak. Bree Anna Ferguson. Kyle R. Fredekind.
Thanks, everybody. I told myself I wouldn't cry. I'm just kidding. Thanks, bye.
Carla Gall.
Oh my God.
Yay! 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 Yay!
Daniel Graham. Caitlin Mary Hamrich.
Congratulations, everyone.
Tyler Hoff.
Woo! Woo!
Thanks, everybody. I love you all.
Cody John Holm. Luke Matthew Hopkins. Manpreet Kerr. Emily E. King.
Hi guys, Parker and Isaac, congratulations. Sorry we can't be there in person. Love you guys.
Ryan Lynn Lagomarsino.
Ryan, miss you.
Jacob R. Milner.
Thank you, everybody.
Brittany J. Miner. Kyle Patrick Robles. Bianca Ray Serafini.
Woo! That's my girl.
Woo! Congrats, everyone. You are so.
Annan Jacob Sheffield.
Proud of you guys.
Mark Patrick Smiley. Julia Ann Snyder.
Yay!
Lauren Elaine True. Alexandra Nicole Trotter.
Yay!
Congrats, everybody.
Morgan D. Umphreys.
Thanks. Congrats, everybody.
Yana Vladimirovna Vistorovskaya. Spencer Jeffrey Winberry.
Yeah!
Heidi Nicole Humans.
Yeah, it's over.
Almost. Anna I. Zakharova.
Yay!
Congratulations, Spokane, class 22. I am super proud of you, and I am proud to have 32 new PAs in the community who can take care of me as I'm getting older. I would come and see any one of you at any time. Now I will turn the virtual podium back over to our program director and section head, Terry Scott.
Thank you, Michael. And let me echo your same sentiments. I'm so proud of each and every one of you. And thank you for sharing your family and with us. Absent of being in together, it's really nice to be able to see the enthusiasm from your family. So this ends this, and I want to just say congratulations to the graduating class of Spokane Class 22, and welcome to the MEDEX alumni. Go out there and save the world. And let me tell you, the world you're entering in is so different than the one you entered when you started this program 2 years ago. There are a need for healers, and the ranks of the healers can never be enough. And I am so proud to add Spokane Class 22 to the MEDEX alumni and to the group of healers that are going to be sent forth into the world to heal and try to nurture this world. So thank you all. Congratulations. Do us proud. So this ends the formal ceremony. And before I do that, I would like to say thank you to Heidi for doing a wonderful job of emceeing this virtual event. Thank you to the Spokane faculty for all the hard work that you do. And thanks to the family. Congratulations, graduates, and have a wonderful, wonderful career. Thank you.
Well done, Spokane.
Woo-hoo. Congrats, guys.
Good work, everybody.
Good job, everybody.
We'll miss you guys.
Congrats. Oh, I muted everyone.
Thank you, professors.
Congratulations, everyone. Thank you, everyone.
Guys, congratulations.
Yay, everyone.
Yeah. Is that it? Congratulations, everyone. We did it.
Congrats, everybody. Nice to see you all, metaphorically.